Opposites attract, and here I am, the living proof of it. Every time I fall in love, I make a goof of it. Drawn to the ones I know are bad. Fatal attractions I shouldn't have had. I have a penchant for heartache, I guess. So I obsess, I yearn and burn for love no sane woman could want in return. Newt, I think you're cute. You speaker of that house of ill repute. In my personal Oz, you are the wizard. Your mama took one look and named you after a lizard. Newt, I can't refute. As a fantasy, there's just no substitute. You look so Newtonian in your statesman drag, like 10 pounds of baloney in a 6-pound bag. Newt, do I smell brute? When you're on TV, I hit the mute. Then I pretend you're singing me a love song that will never be. If I ran up your flagpole, you'd salute. But that's pie in the sky when you carry a torch for a guy like my guy.
Now, what was that all about? Let's just call it jet lag, okay? You know, the French have a wonderful expression for jet lag. They call it décalage horaire. Don't you think that's gorgeous? Oh, such a poetic-sounding malady. Actually, I think for some couples, just having to be apart for long stretches of time can cause a sort of sickness, a sort of homesickness. Now, some people cope with that in different ways. Some people cope by just shutting down a part of themselves. And quite honestly, I think men have a tendency to do that even more than women. Really, I think men have a harder time of it on their own. And the funny thing is, you can usually tell when it's happened. You hear it in a person's voice.